A public outcry after a Moultonboro father was sent to prison yesterday.
Ward Byrd was convicted of felony criminal threatening in 2006, and now the state Supreme Court has upheld that conviction. Prosecutors say he threatened a woman with a gun who came onto his property looking for directions. Friends and family say that's not true and that he was defending his property. Gene Mackin has more on the outrage over the crime and the punishment.
Well, Ward Byrd was convicted by a jury of felony criminal threatening, and because a firearm was involved, state law says he must serve a mandatory 3 to 6 year sentence, a sentence questioned by the judge himself. And now hundreds of people in Ward Byrd's community.
Free Ward Byrd! Free Ward Byrd! Free Ward Byrd!
It is the cry of a growing campaign.
Free Ward Byrd! Free Ward Byrd!
These supporters want to free Ward Byrd. They say it's an injustice the Moultonboro father is behind bars at the state prison after the state Supreme Court upheld his 2006 conviction. He was charged after a woman drove up to his Moultonboro home, passed more than a dozen signs marking the private road.
That she was trespassing on my property first.
Ward Byrd's niece says she ran into the woman first. She says the woman told her she was looking for a certain property that was for sale.
So I did give her directions to the property she was looking at, but not to Ward Byrd's house.
Prosecutors say the woman was lost when she approached Byrd's home and that he threatened her with a gun.
By him brandishing and waving a gun around and at her, he had a pistol. She was put in fear of imminent bodily harm.
Ward Byrd's family and friends say that's not true. They say he asked her repeatedly to leave, that she refused, and he only showed the gun to defend his property.
He didn't commit a crime. He defended his property, and we should be able to defend our property.
Now dozens in this community are tying yellow ribbons, putting up signs on the side of the road, posting them on pickup trucks. They say the mandatory 3 to 6 year sentence is an injustice, and the case questions property rights.
Well, because I think he was defending himself on his own property.
Any one of us would do the same thing in the same situation.
We've always been led to believe that you can protect your family and your property.
At sentencing, the judge said he was required by state law to give that 3 to 6 year sentence. The judge said he would have opted for a sentence including work release and home confinement. We were told by the Department of Corrections that it would not consider a program like that until at least 2 years. Reporting live, Gene Mackin, WMUR News 9.